Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Bunny Says. I'd like to welcome you to another edition of the Testament of Sherlock Holmes Let's Play. Last we left off, we were dealing with the Samoan necklace that seemed to have been stolen and found. But then it seems to be the opinion of a newspaper that Sherlock Holmes may have switched a fake and kept the original. Slander, if you ask me. But let's resume our game. And yes, of course, we were sitting here, and Watson insisted we look at the fake. Now, let's talk to Watson for a moment. Let's see what he has to say.
What do you think, Holmes?
Yes, he wants me to look at the... Okay, so let's
What do you think, Holmes?
Let's see this exact, okay, why?
What do you think, Holmes?
Oh, I'm still talking to him. Okay. Okay. I think, look at this necklace. Who has it? Let's take a look. I have my sixth sense on. Let's take a look. Oh, what was that? I would certainly like to look at the... Here we go. The necklace. Find out if the necklace is authentic or not. This pearl looks so suspicious.
This pearl is a different color.
These
three pearls are of poor quality.
About the main piece.
This pearl is a different color.
I don't remember this now. Back when we were... Let's rotate this a little bit. I want to see if there's something... On the back, maybe?
This pearl is too small. It is not in its place here. Too many defects. This necklace is a fake.
This is nothing but a vulgar copy, and at a glance it would appear that the forger has intended for it to be seen as such.
How could we have been fooled by such a blatant imitation? I don't understand.
Yes, how is it possible? Holmes, do you have a theory about this?
I have absolutely no idea. You insisted that I examine the necklace, and I have done so. Now it is important that I keep my appointment. I'm sure, Inspector, that you will throw some light on this affair.
Holmes!
You may accompany me, Watson, if you care to do so.
Goodbye, gentlemen. I'll keep you informed as to my inquiries.
Goodbye, Inspector. You mentioned a bishop, didn't you? Are we going to his home?
Yes, the Bishop of Knightsbridge. I put his address on our map of London on my desk. Would you get it for me, please?
All right, Holmes.
Oh, okay. His desk. Where is it? Here.
I have found your map.
This is it. Wow. Okay. It's rather... It's rather complicated map here. Okay, I would like to look at that map again. Can I do that? Okay, guess not. Okay. Map. Okay, that is... Okay, map. This is the Diocese of Nightbridge. Oh, did I just fast travel there? Okay.
The police? Already? How did you know?
May we see the Bishop of Knightsbridge?
Yes. Yes, of course. But come in.
What has happened, Reverend?
Some type of friar.
What? I don't know. It was last night, I think. I only just arrived, and I have made this macabre discovery. My God. How horrible. I haven't called anyone. How did you know that?
Holmes, look!
The bishop, appallingly mutilated.
How dreadful.
Mutilated? And killed? He was such a good man. How could anyone be so brutal? Look at him. He is barely recognizable now. How could any of God's children be responsible for that?
They were evidently unworthy children, Reverend. Now do please try to calm yourself and focus, because we will need your assistance. Do you have any idea as to the motive behind this?
I haven't had time to do an inventory, but nothing appears to have been stolen. And anyway, His Excellency didn't own anything of great value. I don't know what else I can tell you.
Note this down, please, Doctor.
Doctor? But you aren't the police?
No, Reverend. I am Sherlock Holmes, and this is Dr. Watson. We are here at the request of the Bishop.
In that case, I must ask you to leave, and not to touch anything. I must get in touch with the authorities without further delay.
Reverend, when the inspectors of Scotland Yard find themselves at a dead end, which they quite often do, I assure you, then they turn to me for help. If you will allow us to continue our investigation, then you shall have the answers to all of your questions.
Out of the question! I don't even know you! I'm going to call the police, whether you like it or not.
It would be better for everyone, Reverend, if you kept your temper. Watson, are you taking notes? This affair promises to be a complex one. Therefore, we must not overlook the slightest detail.
Yes, Holmes. I am keeping a meticulous set of notes. I have created a very clever deduction board. One thing we can be sure of at the moment is that this crime was not for gain. The Reverend has informed us that nothing valuable was stolen. And indeed, it would seem that the Bishop had nothing of any worth to take.
Very good, Watson. Do continue.
Excellent. Make the right decisions, deductions, and... okay. I didn't get that. The bishop didn't own anything of value, not even in his safe. Okay. I imagine we have to gather more clues. Make the right deductions based on the facts you have. Okay, let's close this. Oh, I got something. Elementary, it seems you share my love of all that is bizarre. You discovered the Samoa necklace, well done. Okay. Oh, wow, there's a lot of rewards. I guess you get little rewards during the game. Okay. Let's go back. New control, Sherlock Holmes. The decor in this place is, I have to admit, they're fabulous. I mean, they're really incredible.
The picture of Peregrine Maitland, commander of the infantry brigade of Her Majesty's Guards at Waterloo.
The Bishop of Knightsbridge has the same name as his ancestor, an illustrious family.
Let's see what this bottom thing is here.
A whip?
No, whip.
It is a discipline for self-flagellation.
Okay, if you don't know what flagellation is, you whip yourself, generally in the back. In religious doctrine, it's considered, if you harm yourself, you're atoning for the sins of the world.
It's a cilice designed to bruise the person wearing it. The bishop wore it as repentance. This very pious man must have had the habit of mortifying his flesh as a means of repentance.
So, now, at the time, I mean, it would be, sometimes you could say it's a sadistic, but a lot of people in the time considered it a really holy, holy calling. Okay. What is this? Okay.
Impossible to open it.
Oh, okay.
I am missing some information. I need something.
Okay, these...
These traces reveal that the thieves tried to open this chest.
I expect I can't open it without...
I need something. Impossible to open it.
I guess I need some kind of pins or something, or...
Impossible to open it.
I'll come back to this later. I imagine I need some kind of pins here, chess pieces. Anything else here going on? Okay.
Reverend, I'm missing something, an implement with which to open this chest. Could you tell me where to find it?
No, go to the devil!
What are you afraid of, Reverend? What is inside the chest?
I'm not afraid of anything. In fact, I do have the necessary implements, but if I have to give them to anyone, it will be to a representative of the law and no one else.
Okay, that's rather reasonable, I guess. See if you can talk to him.
You have no right to search here.
Okay. Look at some of these other... What do we have here? Bloody quill. What is it?
A surgical scalpel covered in blood.
Scalpel. Okay. I guess I would look. Like to look at the. Body in a minute. Oh, what's this on the rug?
A broken phial and blood near the neck.
What a strange smell. Chemical components, I think.
Okay. Let's take a look at here.
There is blood on this paperweight.
Maybe it was used to bludgeon the person to knock them out.
A broken bottle of whiskey. However, the Bishop of Knightsbridge was known for his sobriety.
So someone bashed him over the head to knock him out?
A bottle of whiskey. I can make out fingerprints stained with blood and dirt.
It would seem that the brutes who tortured the bishop to death were intoxicated with alcohol.
Possibly they forced him to drink before he died.
This stove is filled to overflowing.
Possibly to get rid of the scent of the dying body. Now let's look at this body. Rather horrific. Fingers are all broken and flesh is mutilated. Yes, looks like torture.
The fingers have been crushed and violently struck. The fingers have been crushed and violently struck.
Okay. Stomach seems to have some kind of
His stomach is covered in scratches. Quite evidently, they weren't made recently.
So, these wounds were not made by his murderers.
I don't know about that. But let's take his word for it.
His forearms have been ripped. Pieces of skin have been torn off. What do you think, Watson?
I'd say that he was eaten alive. Yet I've noticed a curious degeneration of the skin tissue around the wounds.
Really? Degeneration of skin tissue. Possibly he was diseased or ill. Let's see what we got here.
A piece of rope that was used to tie up that poor man.
Okay. Yes. What is this, a scalpel? And let's look at my inventory for a moment. Broken flask, rope, scalpel, pocket knife, matches. Let's see if this,
The fingers have been crushed and violently struck.
Okay. I believe I have all the evidence here. I really want to look at his head. So let's get out and look at his face here.
You can see by his expression that he suffered terribly.
His mouth is covered in blood, and I can make out strips of skin between his teeth. My dear friend, everything points to this man having gnawed at his own forearms.
That's unbelievable, Holmes.
Gnawed at his own forearms? What are these scars on his chest?
His chest has been lacerated, I would say, with a very sharp and fine blade. There isn't any doubt the wounds on the bishop were administered with this scalpel.
Assume that for now. This is rather interesting. Is there anything on his face here? On his body, on his parchment, his Let's see if I can match up these scalpel.
His chest has been
here.
Lacerated, I would say, with a very sharp and fine blade.
Okay, maybe not. I thought maybe I can match up the scalpel wounds with the...
You can see by his expression that he suffered terribly.
His mouth is covered in blood, and I can make out strips of skin between his teeth.
Is this again? Rope, okay. Maybe I could use the pocket knife to collect some samples. No, I guess not. by that brutal and vicious man over here. Let's go back. How about these pokers? Were any of them used to... Okay. Okay, here we go. I want to look at this fireplace. Again. No.
This stove is filled to overflowing.
Now, why would they fill it to overflowing?
You have no right to search here.
Okay, I want to talk to Watson.
I cannot leave now.
Oh, okay.
Watch where you're putting your feet, Watson. Have you noticed these prints upon the ground?
Well, yes, those muddy marks.
See here, Watson. Footprints can often provide more vital information than the very best of informants.
Yes, if you know how to make them talk, that is.
It's child's play, Watson. We will begin by excluding the contaminating prints, which are yours and mine from where we came in, and those of our dear reverend who was so impatient to call the police.
Interesting.
A fragment of stone. Peculiar.
Yes.
Well-worn shoes with an odd pattern on the soles.
I'm guessing these sort of circular holes here.
Hobnail boots like those worn by laborers.
Okay, I guess those are the nails.
Hobnail boots like those worn by laborers. Hobnail boots like those worn by laborers.
Okay, now this footprint is different.
This print came from an expensive pair of shoes, and it seems recent. It is not a laborer's shoe.
Interesting.
Hobnail boots like those worn by laborers. Nothing of interest here.
Anything in these corners here? Let's take some measurements of the...
Size 9.
Okay. And the hobnail boots are...
Size 9. Size 9.5.
Really?
Size 9. Size 9. Size 9.5.
So at the very least, we can imagine that there are two people here.
Nothing of interest here.
This is a size 9 and a size 9.5. How many girls were there? Let's say 2.
That's not right. Start again.
Okay, well, at least 1, I guess.
That's not right. Start again.
Really? Let's take a look. There is 1, 2... Looks like 3.
Perfect. We now know that there were 3 crooks.
Okay. Because this, the footprint here, they don't have the same hobnails. This footprint. And obviously this is from a new boot. Okay, question 2. What do the footprints reveal? One man joined those who were already in the room. One man left the room wearing different shoes. One man was carried so as not to leave the footprints. All men left the room jumping on one leg. Let me look at this again. Let's see, we have hobnail guy. coming in and turning around, standing there, another guy standing here, and then this guy, well, maybe these two people were standing there, and this guy entranced. Okay, I'm going to say one man joined us.
That's not right. Start again.
Okay, really? One man left the room wearing different shoes? Can't believe that.
Strange, but true. One of the crooks was wearing a different pair of shoes when he left here.
Therefore, we have three men who came in and left again. But one of them was wearing a different pair of shoes from the ones which he came in with.
So, all we have to do is look for a workman who likes Italian shoes.
I don't think it's that easy. Let's talk to Watson again.
What do you think, Holmes?
See what the Reverend has
to say.
You have
no right to search here.
Well, I have a great deal of right, actually. But the stone. Oh, what? Oh, this guy. Yeah, there's a new clue down the bottom there. Oh, okay.
It's a cilice designed to bruise the person wearing it. The bishop wore it as repentance.
Okay. Okay, let me get out of here. Anything else here for me to look at? Now, green means that I already looked at it. Anything on the rug at all? How about over here?
This door has not been forced. Where does it lead, Reverend?
To His Excellency's room. There is just a mattress and a stool.
Really? Let's take a look.
The bishop's bedroom. It is very austere. Nothing in particular here.
Okay, you see it's a nice plant. Was he writing anything? No, I guess not. Let's see, here we have...
I cannot leave now.
Okay, that's leaving. Okay. Look at this place here.
Closed. The veranda door hasn't been forced. Strange. Reverend, might I have the key?
No! You have no authority here. Let me call the police.
Perhaps we should listen to him, Holmes.
Perhaps you should let me get on with this, Watson. Closed.
Can I pick this lock at all? Maybe he left his key in his room, or... So suspicious about this fire. I mean...
This stove is filled to overflowing.
Like somebody was trying to burn something. Okay, let's talk to the bishop.
You have no right to search here.
I know that, but...
You have no right to search here.
Don't you? Okay, I need a key. Apparently, to get into this.
Closed.
Okay, how do we open that? There's a puzzle here.
I am missing some information. I need something.
Now, do I... Oh, let me... Okay. Close. Okay, can I click on any of these?
Impossible to open it. I need something. I need something.
Okay, I guess I need... Are there any... What's in my inventory? What is that in my inventory? What is that thing there? A broken flask, scalpel, pocket knife, rope, matches, stone fragment. Let's try the stone fragment. Let's take a look at this.
Impossible to open it. I am missing some information. Impossible to open it.
Okay. Is there anything on the desk?
There is blood on this paperweight. This paperweight was used to crush the victim's fingers.
Okay.
A bottle of whiskey. I can make out fingerprints stained with blood and dirt.
A broken bottle of whiskey. However, the Bishop of Knightsbridge was known for his sobriety.
Okay. There must be something on the body, I guess. Oh, okay, I didn't check the legs.
These burns are terrible.
This poor man was tied just below the knees.
To stop him from walking, certainly, but mostly to free his feet.
His feet have been burned.
My first impression is that he wears a size 9 shoe.
You? But what does it matter, Holmes? My God, Holmes, this man was horribly tortured.
Yes, he was. Now... Is there anything else interesting here? Other than this
a finger.
Tone?
Apparently, it doesn't belong to the Bishop of Knightsbridge.
How dreadful!
Really? So. The finger doesn't belong to him. So somebody else lost their finger. Okay. Let's look at this finger. Is there anywhere else I haven't checked in this guy? I checked his entire chest and legs and... Okay. Let's check the fire.
Something is missing here.
Oh yes? And what might that be?
His shoes. Watson, his shoes are missing. This stove is filled to overflowing.
Let's take a look at this. His shoes. Can I get through here now?
Closed.
Okay, can I use the... Wait, the shoes are in his room. No. Maybe I could use the thumb on the puzzle. Okay, we know this. Sorry, anything else I'm missing here? No. Let's try the...
I need something.
What a finger.
Impossible to open it. Impossible to open it. Impossible to open it.
Okay. Let's look at this picture again. No. New picture. Okay, I give it a rock, and now, did somebody come in through the window?
You have no right to search here.
Why am I keeping my right?
Let us look at our deduction board, Watson.
Okay, alright, what's this about? Investigation of the Bishop of Knightsbridge murder. Left. The bishop's shoes are missing. One of the murderers left in different shoes. Okay, the conclusion I would imagine is that he took the bishop's shoes. One of the murderers left wearing the bishop's shoes. Okay, and what do we got here? One of the murderers sell shoes. Let's go back to that. Shoes. Okay. Lack. Shoes. The bishop didn't own anything of value, but not even his safe. Okay. Wealth. Okay. I guess that was wealth. Veranda. The veranda wasn't searched. That means they were going straight after the bishop. Runners were looking for something specific. Yes, I'll say that. Okay, maybe not. They took the murderers. No? I think they were looking for something specific. And the bishop came in on them. And they tortured him to try to find out where it was. Okay, the chest. The murderers were unable to open the safe. Okay, we know that. Torture. The victim was savagely tortured. Okay, that didn't help much. Penitence. The bishop was mortifying himself. He was used to pain. The bishop resisted torture. The bishop punished himself too severely. I imagine he resisted the torture, because they tortured him a lot. Okay. The murderers came here to kill the bishop. The bishop's murderers got what they wanted. The bishop's murderers didn't get what they wanted. I don't think they got what they wanted. I think it's in the safe. Okay, the bishop. The bishop nodded himself. You know that. The flask. The broken flask has some blood at its top. So, they made him drink it after they tortured him a little bit. The murderers made the bishop drink blood. The murderers made the bishop drink the contents of the flask. The murderers tortured the bishop with the broken glass. I'm gonna say they forced him to drink the contents of the flask. Okay, maybe not. Yeah, I'm gonna say they made him drink the contents of the flask after they tortured him a bit. So, what do we have going on here? So the bishop's murderers didn't get what they wanted. They're trying to get into the chest, but... Okay, one of the murderers sell shoes. The murderers are poor. One of the murderers came back for his shoes. I think I'll try that. And the bishop's murderers were hired by someone. The murderers searched for the bishop's shoes. The murderers wanted to steal from the bishop. I'll assume that. They were trying to get into that safe. Wow, this is really complicated. Do I have any of this right? Does the green mean it's right and the blue mean it's wrong? Or that I didn't get it? Let's quit this for now.
Let us look at our deduction board, Watson.
Okay. Let's start with the green part here. Okay.
Let us look at our deduction board, Watson.
Okay, I did that. The victim was savagely tortured. The murderers were unable to open the safe. So we got that. The chest, the torture, and the penitence. Okay. Now I'm guessing here. The bishop's shoes are missing. One of the murderers left wearing the bishop's shoes. I believe that's correct. One of the murderers left in different shoes. We know that. Well, let me... No? Okay. One of the murderers came back for his shoes. One of the murderers sell shoes? Or the murderers are poor? I think the murderer came back for his shoes. Murderers wanted to steal from the bishop. Murderers wanted to steal, search for the bishop's shoes. The bishop's murderers were hired by someone. That. Well, I don't know that. The murderers searched for the bishop's shoes. Murderers want to steal from the bishop. I'll say that's correct. The murderers will look for something specific. Well, maybe the bishop might have taken the people by surprise. I think they were looking for something specific. The bishop didn't know anything about it, not even safe. Okay. The veranda wasn't searched. I haven't got in there yet. Okay. That's what I'm going to have to do for right now. Let's talk to this guy again.
You have no right to search here.
Listen, I want to get into the veranda.
Closed.
Do I have a key? Or can I use
closed.
The on the... How about this
closed.
Guy?
Closed.
Okay, rope.
Closed. Closed.
Rock. Okay, let's go into his room for a minute. Is there anything in the room that's funky? Is he writing anything? No? Pretty austere room. How about the rug? The only thing is this, I got the...
This metal rod is for fastening the chilies.
Oh. Oh, I've got to be more careful. Was it? Okay, hold on. Because there might be stuff on the... Okay. Okay, that makes something different. What was the item I had? Wait a minute. Okay. No, that's... Okay. What was the thing about the chalice? The middle stick? Oh, can I use that to picklock the veranda? Let's try that.
Closed.
Let's get the...
Closed.
Well, not for sure that would work. Maybe the chessboard I could use.
I am missing some information. Impossible to open it.
Okay. I have a stock to...
Let us look at our deduction board, Watson.
Okay. Shoes, lack, wealth, and veranda. I haven't gotten to the veranda yet. The chest, the torture, the penitence. Okay. The bishop nodded himself. The broken flask has some blood at its top. The murderers made the bishop drink the contents of the flask. They made the bishop drink blood? That might be correct. Shoes are missing. What are they different? That's sort of difficult, isn't it? Okay. I'm not going anywhere. I'm gonna look at this for a while. Okay, this is a metal stick. How do I examine
it? Let us look
it?
At our deduction board, Watson.
Okay, I want to... Yep.
Let us look at our deduction board, Watson.
Okay, how do I do that? Okay, I want to look at my inventory. Do I actually have to use a stone fragment? How do I examine those items?
Closed. Closed.
I want to get into this veranda. And the bishop isn't helping me.
Closed. 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 Closed.
Okay. Is there anything here that... Can I see anything around or in the background? Okay, what's this book here? I just did another one. What?
I cannot leave now.
Okay.
Let us look at our deduction board, Watson.
Okay, it's the same as before, I believe. Okay.
Stop. You have no right to search here.
Reverend. Reverend, you're not very helpful. There's a man dead here, your bishop.
The bishop's bedroom. It is very austere. Nothing in particular here.
Now if I close the door, will that make any... Can I look at his stuff on his desk here? Or... Okay, guess not. Is there anything under this rug? Okay.
There is blood on this paperweight.
Okay, I get that. Any of these windows opened at all?
A broken bottle of whiskey. However, the Bishop of Knightsbridge was known for his sobriety.
What about this? Stop, stop. Okay.
A bottle of whiskey. I can make out fingerprints stained with blood and dirt.
That means he was tortured and stuff beforehand.
This stove is filled to overflowing.
Now this makes me wonder about this stove. Let me look at the body again. Is there something I might have missed? Legs, the feet, my hands, maybe his teeth or his face? Or okay, now I'm getting all green. Well, maybe his shoulder. His chest, we did that.
His chest has been lacerated, I would say, with a very sharp and fine blade.
Okay, let's take a look at the scalpel we picked up and see if that has anything to do with it.
His chest has been lacerated, I would say, with a very sharp and fine blade.
Okay.
You can see by his expression that he suffered terribly.
His mouth is covered in blood, and I can make out strips of skin between his teeth.
Really? Okay, let me look at his mouth.
You can see by his expression that he suffered.
His mouth is covered in...
Can I look at his mouth? Skin in his mouth. Or... Oh, I saw blue there. No. Okay. It's quite difficult. Let's see where else in his body we could look. Let's look at his hands. He might be holding something. Okay, his clothes. What? Okay. His legs are clean. His hands.
The fingers have been crushed and violently struck.
Now I know the paperweight did that. Okay. I mean, I'm imagining the paperweight. I mean, it's got to be something.
a bottle of whiskey. I can make out fingerprints stained with blood and dirt.
Okay. Paperweight is one.
There is blood on this paperweight.
Can I pick it up? Or I guess I can pick it up. You know, on the floor we have broken pieces of a whiskey bottle. Okay, how do I get into the veranda?
This stove is filled to overflowing.
Could I see here?
This stove is filled to overflowing.
Okay.
This stove is filled to overflowing.
Let me match his hands with the thumb.
The fingers have been crushed and violently struck.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, that's interesting. He has all his fingers. But yet I found a finger. So, whose severed finger is that? Wait a minute, hold on. Let's, okay, no inventory. Did I use stuff on other stuff? Like the matches on the okay. There's a broken flask. I wonder if I could use the broken flask on the whiskey bottle.
A bottle of whiskey. I can make out fingerprints stained with blood and dirt.
Okay, I'd rather just have the total whiskey bottle.
A bottle of whiskey. I can make out fingerprints stained with blood and dirt.
Okay. Let's see here. I've got the stone in the fireplace.
This stove is filled to overflowing.
Okay, now let's talk to Doc.
Let us look at our deduction board, Watson.
Does that mean I just didn't pick the right things? Well, the only thing I have for Bishop is the Bishop part of himself. Flask. The broken flask has some blood at its top. Okay. The murderers made the Bishop drink blood. The murderers made the Bishop drink the contents of the flask. Maybe they tortured him with broken glass. Okay. I seem to have these done. But I guess these. Okay, the veranda wasn't searched. I haven't got in there yet. The Bishop didn't own anything of value. And even in his safe. The murderers got the wrong person? No. The Bishop took the murderers by surprise. The murderers. I think the murderers were looking for something specific. And one of the murderers left in different shoes. Bishop's shoes are missing. I assume the murderer left in the Bishop's shoes. One of the murderers left wearing the Bishop's shoes. Okay. He didn't have to be a member of the clergy. Oh, wait a minute. He said the things are full, so maybe he threw the Bishop's shoes away. Let's go back for his shoes. I still think he left the Bishop's shoes. The murderers wanted to steal from the Bishop. Am I searching for the bishop's shoes? No. They were there to steal from the bishop. I just want to steal the bishop's shoes. Okay, let's assume they're trying to take the shoes. Well, there's left different shoes. Left wearing... Murderers threw the bishop's shoes away. One of the murderers came back for his shoes. And the murderers searched for the bishop's shoes to... After his shoes? I need to get into the veranda. Okay, this is getting on very long. This is much past an hour. So, I'm going to stop here. I'm going to actually look up how to get into the veranda. I'm not too proficient at this type of game, so I'm going to use a little bit of walkthrough to see if I can figure out. I'm not sure about the, I don't want to. I want to figure out how to get through the... How to get to the veranda.
Closed.
Can I use a...
Closed.
I thought I could use the scalpel. Matches?
Closed.
Okay, the fingerprint.
Closed.
That thumb looks nasty, by the way.
Closed.
I need to get into the veranda, I think, to figure out what's going on. I think the only way into the veranda is this puzzle. And since I can't use my inventory...
Impossible to open it.
I don't... There's nothing to click on, I mean...
These traces reveal that the thieves tried to open this chest.
Yes, and they had as much trouble as me trying to figure out what to...
Impossible to open it.
How to open this chest, so I'm gonna see what's going on, so anyway, this is coming on more than an hour. Is there anything else I can look at? No? Unless I look at the No? Okay, the bottom. Is there anything else on here that I'm missing? No. Is there anything else up here? No. So... What was that? No? Alright, so I'm at a loss. I'm not sure what's going on, so... I will end the file here. It's way past an hour. And I will try to figure out what's going on with this chessboard thing. I don't know what's to put in there. And I assume the only way to get into the veranda is to open that, so... And I don't know how to use the inventory well enough yet to know what to do. Matchsticks?
Impossible to open it. I need something.
Okay. Thing is, I don't know what he needs. Okay. well, I'm going to end this game here. This bunny says is getting on way too long. And I'm going to thank you for joining me. And I'll take a quick look at a walkthrough or a playthrough or something to see, just to get a handle on how puzzles and stuff work in this game. So, thank you for joining me, and I hope you join me again.